We have entered a new field of engineering thanks to the creation of new materials and artificial intelligence. New engines have been created as a result of this evolution, moving from conception to reality. One such engine is the rotating detonation engine, RDE, which produces thrust through detonation, a form of supersonic combustion. The RDE is more efficient than traditional rocket engines and shows promise for a variety of applications. Nevertheless, whether using an RDE or a full flow stage combustion cycle, regulating the exhaust remains a key component. A bell-shaped nozzle is used by conventional liquid-fueled rockets to direct thrust. But as the rocket rises, the exhaust begins to veer off course, reducing the rocket's effectiveness. Multi-stage rockets like the F1 and J2 engines, each of which is tailored for a particular pressure environment, are utilized to overcome this inefficiency at all altitudes. And potential remedy for this problem, at least on paper, is adding a protrusion or spike with a wedge-like shape. Due to restrictions on exhaust expansion imposed by atmospheric pressure at low altitudes, which prohibit the production of a partial vacuum that would lower thrust, this spike proves to be quite effective. The spike adapts to the rocket's altitude and maintains effectiveness as it ascends to greater altitudes when the air pressure drops. The Aerospike offers greater efficiency than the traditional bell shape. Aerospike designs haven't been widely used in the last 50 years, but for a reason. Due to the intense heat and the requirement for additional cooling when expanding gas contacts with the nozzle wall, designing aerospike engines is difficult. The solution to these problems is to create an alloy that is both light and heat resistant. Additionally, the aerospike's particular shape, such as the linear L-spike design, can affect how effective it is. The linear aerospike has promise, especially for single-stage to orbit rockets. But adding multiple engines for lighter payload delivery rockets makes it economically unviable. As a result, it can take some time before the linear aerospike is used in real life. The toroidal spike stands out among the numerous aerospike designs because it can be included into a single rocket engine configuration, making scaling it easier. This design is being pursued by a number of smaller businesses, including Pangea Aerospace, using additive manufacturing and a recently created copper alloy by NASA. The efficiency of this high-strength alloy is around 15% higher than that of traditional rocket engines, allowing for up to 10 reuses. Small channels in the toroidal spike engine direct the fuel before it is injected into the main combustion chamber, and the spiral shape of the channels helps coolant flow against the engine's walls. Additionally, CAD methods coupled with the Titan core processor, a cutting-edge technology, have tremendous potential for engine design. With accurate Mach number distribution and flow calculations, this state-of-the-art method enables quick engine chamber building and optimization. From spinning detonation engines to aerospike propulsion, the transformative force of algorithmic engineering can change engine design, launching humanity into a new era of space propulsion. It's important to note that this new technology has not yet demonstrated its affordability and dependability in comparison to more proven engines like the Raptor or -25 rupees. It must first undergo extensive testing before being put into use. The use of algorithmic engineering, however, has the potential to revolutionize engine construction and might potentially have effects that transcend beyond space propulsion. In conclusion, new avenues for engine design have been made possible by developments in materials, manufacturing, and AI. These advancements, whether they include algorithmic engineering, versions of the aerospike, or the RDE, represent a substantial stride forward in the realm of space propulsion. The potential for innovation and advancement in engine design is intriguing and hopeful, even though difficulties in testing are still to come. Furthermore, it's crucial to remember that while these technical innovations have a lot of potential, it's equally necessary to get people's ideas and comments on them. Please let me know what you think about this. If you enjoyed the video, feel free to like it and don't forget to subscribe to my channel for more videos like this.